But let me bring in my friend and colleague, HLN's Erica Hill, who used to sit there at CBS, round the table with Charlie Rose on CBS This Morning, and today has shared this impassioned message about the way she and so many other women have been mistreated at work.
I haven't been physically assaulted, and it is really sad that I consider myself almost lucky to have avoided that. But the news of especially these past 2 days has brought back a lot of moments I realize now I had blocked out, and it has been an emotional kick to my gut, and it's also helped me find my voice. A lot of those moments I blocked out until last night, when friends and former colleagues and my husband reminded me of far too many moments they had witnessed and that I had shared. The boss who, when I was 21, told me we should go for coffee, or he just wouldn't be able to stop himself from coming across the desk to kiss me. I laughed it off at the time. I went for coffee to get out of that uncomfortable office. Because I was too smart to fall for those games, I told myself. He'd put his moves on the wrong woman. Or the man who so many journalists looked up to. The one who berated me for, in his eyes, not showing enough respect to my new co-anchor by daring to join in on a segment on our show that we were supposed to do together. Or that co-anchor who made it very clear that I was in the way, who decided I would be allowed to speak on our program when he pointed at me. Imagine a 70-year-old man pointing his finger at you. That's the signal that I was allowed to ask a question. What an honor to be given the privilege of doing my job with a point every single day. And sometimes it came with a smile. Did that mean I was supposed to thank him? And yet I wondered, when are these or any other moments were worthy of your time? Because I chalked them up to no big deal, because that's what we do if we want to keep our jobs and get ahead. We don't rock the boat. Don't get so upset about a dirty old man. Stop being so sensitive. But the truth is, every single moment is worthy, because when we stay silent and when we downplay the bullying, the misogyny, the harassment, the uncomfortable moments, all we do is fuel their game. And we let them win in their quest to remind us who they believe holds all the power. But the truth is, they don't hold all the power anymore.
Yes, Erica Hill.
Thank you.
Thank you for doing that.
Thanks.
That was a big moment. It's a big moment for me to share just here with you, for you to have the courage to say what you did. So thank you. And then just when you read that Washington Post piece about Charlie Rose, about all the accusations.
I had to stop a couple times when I was reading it. I think a lot of people did. It was incredibly well done. Phenomenal reporting and very detailed. And the allegations of these situations that these women put forth were, I want to be very clear, nothing that I had experienced mm-hmm. with Charlie Rose. Mm-hmm. But it just was a kick in the gut to think that, A, anyone could be treated that way mm-hmm. and could be put in that position. And it was disturbing, it was disappointing, and it made my blood boil. And it just got me to thinking about also, you know, what I see in many ways in our industry, because this is where we work, but across the board, if we look at different interactions, and they're not always physical, there's a clear abuse of power. And I think a lot of what we're seeing and what women are and men are coming forward and speaking about now all goes back to this need to remind women who is in charge, mm-hmm. who is the person in power, and who they should, you know, in some ways bow down to, for lack of a better phrase.
Yes. But what you were talking about, you know, stories that we've all maybe through our careers told our girlfriends or our mm-hmm. boyfriends or husbands, and now what was the click for you to think, oh, wait, after all these many years, maybe that wasn't okay?
You know, it was talking with friends.
Yeah.
And after I spoke with Aaron last night, I was just getting texts from friends and former colleagues and even talking with my husband at home. And I had shared with someone, you know, that there was a program I worked on where it was decided that I should wait basically until it was my turn to speak, and that would be determined when my co-anchor decided. And so the signal that was decided upon was that there would be a point. And I shared that with someone, and I haven't hidden this. I've talked about this openly with friends and family for a long time, and everybody who worked on that set knew it and saw it. But all of a sudden, the reaction that I got yesterday was one of absolute horror and disgust. And someone said, are you kidding me? That's so terrible. How could that happen? And then I just thought about a lot of things. And people were texting me about moments that I had shared with them that I had completely forgotten about, and comments and observations I had made and things that had been said to me. And all of a sudden, I realized demeaning someone and trying to damage them, whether it is of a sexual nature or not, is not okay. And we can't grade these moments and say, well, mine's not as bad because it wasn't this. It's different. But they all add up to something that is a lasting scar on people.
Thank you for saying that. Erica Hill, thank you so much.
Appreciate it.